So next we'll be seeing interval plot in Minitab. So interval plot. Interval plot is used to see that how a subgroup of data is trending over an interval. We can see that how mean of the subgroup is trending over a time period. Now, the each bar indicates the mean as middle point and the bar has 95% confidence interval from the mean. Now we have a set of data here. So for each subgroup, we'll plot the interval plot over a period of time, how the 95% confidence interval and the mean is trending. Procedure to calculate or to do interval plot. Capture the data on hourly basis for the same output. Paste the data in the Minitab spreadsheet. Go to graph interval plot. Select multiple wise interval plot. Select the data in the graph variable box. Go to scales reference line. In the y-axis, enter the lower and upper spec by giving this space and say okay and say okay. So now we will get the interval plot like this. So 9 to 10 a.m. this is how the data is distributed. That means the mean is around something, 2 point something, and these two lines indicates the 95% confidence interval with lower and upper limit. And you can see the data is trending like this, and between these time limits it's producing okay, and 1 to 2 p.m. there is a out of specification. Now so we will get the below interval plot and we can observe how the mean is trending over a period of time and also along with the 95% confidence interval of the to me. So now let us see how to calculate or to do the interval plot. So we have the data here already for the different time periods. Now go to graph, then go to interval plot, select multiple wise interval plot, then select the data, double click all the data that we have in the columns, go to scales reference line, give the specification limit by giving the space for lower and higher specification limit and save okay and save okay. So we got the interval plot and how it is trending. Now so next we'll see probability plot in Minitab. Probability plot is used to see the p-value, that is a normality test for a given set of data, and when the data is collected in a different category wise, we can use the previous data and plot the probability plot. Procedure to do the probability plot: go to graph probability plot, select the data, tick graph variables from the group and say okay. We can observe the p-value for all the category at once. So now we have a data of same dimension with variety of categories, or in a different days you are collected, you want to observe the p-value at a time for all the set of data, then we can use this probability plot. So let us calculate probability plot. So we have the data here, go to graph, then go to probability plot, then select multiple probability plot and select all the data by double clicking and go tick that graph variables from groups and say okay. So now you can observe the p value for all the categories. So this is how we can make probability plot. Now next let us see how to do regression plot in Minitab with formula. Regression plot. Regression is defined as to know the relationship between the two variables statistically, to know the relation between two variables statistically. Here we can use the concept of y is equal to function of x, where y is a response and x is the input, where y can be named as a response and x can be named as a predictor. Okay. Let us see an example of regression plotting for the below data. Now we have the data here where load and dimensions. What is load? Load is the input and dimension is the output. Now procedure to do regression plot in Minitab. Collect the y and x data respectively and paste it in the Minitab spreadsheet. Go to stat, regression, fitted line plot. Select the output in the response y box and select the input in the predictor x box and say Okay, so then it will come, we'll get a regression plot like this along with the formula. Now there is no correlation here, so we can conclude that there is no correlation between the load and the dimension because R square value is less than 0%. Now let us do in the Minitab. So we have the data here, so we need to go to start regression fitted line plot. So in the response y is the output, that is output is the dimension, so predictor load is the input, then say okay. So now you can see there is no correlation. This way we can do the regression plot along with the formula in the Minitab. So what does the formula say? If you want particular dimension, so we can find out what is the load if there is a 90% correlation. Now there is a one more example data. Let us observe the regression plot for the another set of data. In the below example, we can conclude that there is a correlation between load and the dimension. Now we have the data here, they are plotted. So 100% there is a correlation. We get a formula saying that dimension is equal to 3.90 plus O1 times the load. So if you want particular dimension, we can find out what is the load since there is a correlation. At least it should be more than 75% correlation in order to do some experiments. Now let us do the regression plot in Minitab for this data. So go to start regression fitted line plot. Here select response as the dimension, predictor as the load, and say okay. Now we can see we have got the formula as well as there is 100% correlation. This is how we can do regression plot analysis with formula in the Minitab. Next, regression plot in Excel with formula. Regression plot in Excel. We can create the regression plot in Excel, paste the data in the Excel spreadsheet, select the data for both Y and X, select insert scatter diagram with smooth line curve. Save OK. Right click on the line in the graph and add trend line. At the bottom of the option, tick display equation on the chart and also R squared value on the chart. Now you will find the R squared value and the equation on the chart. Now if you see, we can do in the Excel for the same two set of data. We can find out this regression curve as well as we can find the formula. So let us do in the Excel. So now we have the formula, select the data, go to insert, then go to scatter with scatter plot with line. So we got the regression graph. Right click on the graph, go to add trend line. At the bottom, select display equation on the chart and display R square on the chart. So now we got the formula as well as the R square value. So there is no much correlation here. For the second example, select the data, go to insert, go to scatter plot with line and click on the line in the graph and give add trend line at the bottom, select display equation on the chart and display R square value on the chart. Now if you see, it is R square value is 1, that means 100% there is a correlation and this is a formula. So this is how we can make a regression plot along with the formula in the Excel as well. So this also we have done in the Excel. So we get the formula as well as the R square value. So till here we have done interval plot in Minitab, probability plot in Minitab, regression plot in Minitab with formula, and regression plot in Excel with formula. So you can use this analysis in order to do some correlation activity. It can be towards a measurement or towards doing some changes in the machine for some design of experiments or something else. So next we'll see the summary of Six Sigma.